get bloody again as soldiers fight to finish over mass killing of villagers by gunmen. Borno happens to be the first and the most attacked northern state in Nigeria. You see, the governor of Borno, though he's trying, but he needs federal support. In fact, almost all the states in Nigeria needs federal support. But the question is, what is the federal government doing concerning the mass killings in Nigeria? The federal government, from my observation, are also working to save themselves, because even they themselves, they are not safe. They are not safe. So the available military men are kept for their own security. You see that? So I don't know. The only thing Nigeria need is international support. International support. They need international support. Because if they don't go for international support, I'm afraid what is going to befall them is what even they themselves has not experienced before. You understand? I've not experienced before. So it is better that they start negotiating for international support now. Now. Babangida Zulum is one of the very governor that has been working assiduously to the quick eradication of Boko people, yet the state is still getting bloody. In this very broadcast, despite the moves of a Nigerian army in Borno, despite the fact that they fought gallantly, they exchanged gun battle strongly with these bandits in Borno in this very broadcast, yet two of the soldiers were brutally killed, and the civilians, the villagers, oh my God, those ones were killed in mass. They were killed in mass. You see that? So it is getting bloody by the day. It is getting bloody by the day, despite the efforts of the governor. Despite the efforts of the governor. So what then could be the solution to this issue? The only person that have the solution is the president. One, he need to carry out a diligent negotiation. And save the masses from this unnecessary chaos. Because it's getting too much. Let's quickly see what the content has for us. The Nigerian army says troops of Operation Hadinkai foiled Boko people group attempt to infiltrate Rantown, the capital of Kala Bagi local government area of Borno State on Saturday. In a statement on Monday, spokesperson of Nigerian Army Brigadier General Muhammad Yarema said on the 2nd of May 2021, another band of Boko people attacked Ajiri town of Kanduga, local government area of Borno State. He, however, said two soldiers and several civilians were killed, while many houses were burnt by the Boko people in Kanduga. The statement reads in part, "The Boko people in their numbers attempted to disrupt the peace that has been enjoyed by the border town, but were met with stiff resistance as the troops in the area took them on a fierce fight battle, which lasted about an hour. The Boko people withdrew in disarray, with a large number of them suffering fatal injuries, leaving behind several weapons and ammunition, including anti-aircraft gun barrel, AK-47 rifle, handheld communication radio, and different calibers of ammunition." In a related development, on 2nd of May 2021, another band of Boko people group on a criminal mission attack Ajiri town of Kanduga, local government area of Borno State. The Boko people, who had reached a part of the town, initially burnt 9 houses and killed some innocent residents before they were engaged by the troops deployed in the area. The retreating Boko people went away with various degrees of gunshot injuries, while the gallant troops are on their chase. Unfortunately, however, 2 personnel paid the supreme price in the resulting encounter. Thank you for listening to this news. My viewers, you see that our Nigerian army, not that they are not fit, they are fit, but what they need now is to be armed. They need enough arms to get themselves equipped. Because I believe in something. If the Nigerian army, our Nigerian army, our trained Nigerian army are equipped, definitely the fight against Boko people and terrorism will be a minor. But attention is not properly paid. It's not properly paid to these people. They allow them to go to war with belated weapons. With belated weapons. Weapons that has worn out, and once they get to the war front, they start crying for deployment of weapons. Is it supposed to be so? No wonder we see many of our soldiers dying. Let me tell you, all these things are plots of the sponsors of the Boko people. They will intentionally make sure that the troops are not equipped. They are not equipped, so that they will go there and be massacred. Proper investigation need to be carried out on this issue. Because from my findings, the governor of that Sebonu is really working hard. He's really working hard. You understand now? So let there be a quick action on this issue. The federal government, the Buhari, needs to wake up. He needs to wake up and do something concerning the situation, because the situation is no longer something one can just overlook. Okay? So, my dear viewers, I invite you in this very issue to come in at least and air your own opinion concerning all that has been happening in Nigeria, most especially this very state, Borno. In fact, the state is really suffering from attacks. Okay, let me know what is your own opinion, and then what you think the federal government should do to help curb out this menace once and for all. I know that many people have been coming up with ideas. No idea will ever be a waste. We all need to provide ideas, at least. Okay, if you're new on this channel, don't forget to leave your comments below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.